Welcome! In this video, we'll take a look at the wing anti-ice system, particularly its use above flight level 350, which the manual states may cause a bleed trip off. The video will not focus on procedures, which after establishing aircraft control, could potentially lead to performing the bleed trip off, cabin altitude warning, or rapid depressurization checklists. Instead, we will take a look at the system itself, what could happen, and what you can do if accumulating ice at high altitude. Before we start, the preferred use of wing anti-ice is as a de-icer, so should be used if ice has accumulated to remove it, and is not normally used continuously. We're at flight level 360, in icing conditions. Okay, let's turn on both the engine and wing anti-ice. Notice that the lights go bright when the valves are moving, and when not yet in the new commanded position. All good at flight level 360, let's climb to 370. Let's try switching on the engine and wing anti-ice at flight level 370. No issues so far at flight level 370, let's try 380, we can also see if the extra thrust in the climb makes any difference. So far, so good. The preferred method is to use wing anti-ice as a de-icer, so it need only be used for short periods. And there it is, the wing anti-ice lights are bright. The extra thrust has caused the high stage valve to open early, causing a bleed trip off, due to overtemperature. The cabin altitude is climbing rapidly, and the cabin is depressurizing. When the cabin altitude reaches 10,000 feet, the cabin altitude warning light illuminates, and an intermittent oral warning sounds. Turning off the wing anti-ice, providing time for the temperature to cool, then pressing the trip reset, immediately causes the cabin to start pressurizing. Pressing the master caution light does not silence a cabin altitude warning. As soon as the cabin altitude reaches 10,000 feet, the cabin altitude warning stops sounding. If accumulating ice, we must descend or climb out of the weather. Let's descend to flight level 350, where the wing anti-ice should work without issue. Leveling at flight level 350, we switch the wing anti-ice back on, without issue. However, let's consider the alternative. What if we had climbed instead? After receiving TOPS reports on the radio, we may decide to climb above the weather. We can check if we're able to climb to a higher altitude by entering the new altitude in the cruise page of the FMC. Here we can see we are good to climb to flight level 410 if desired. We decide on flight level 390 and set it on the MCP and flight altitude indicator. Climbing above flight level 380, we can see it's clear above. Clearing the tops, we no longer require engine or wing anti-ice. We can take advantage of a smooth ride, lower fuel burn, and also benefit from a bit of a tailwind. We hope you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and learn more about the 737. Thank you.